explain to us how exactly this works. When Americans are expecting more nuclear power to be expanding throughout areas in the United States, where does the waste go, and how is what you're doing different than what has been seen before?
Yeah, so typically what has happened in the U.S. is they've taken this spent nuclear fuel out of the reactor pools and they've moved it into dry cask. It's all stored above ground. Nobody has ever disposed of it anywhere in the world, and we've been producing nuclear power for 70 years. Deep isolation technology is, let's put that in a canister that we can put in a borehole, similar to what we use with directional drilling, deep underground, a mile underground, and permanently keep it out of the biosphere and away from people in a very safe configuration.
Rod, the fact that something like this isn't being done right now kind of scares me. Should it scare me? Is it a problem that we're not using technology to bury this type of waste deep underground at the moment?
No, you should not be worried. Nuclear handling and storage is something we do very safely, and most Americans live within 50 miles of nuclear waste storage. They just don't realize it, and it's because there's just not accidents or troubles with it, and it's handled very safely. But we can do better, and we should do better, and this is costing American taxpayers billions of dollars, and we need to stop that and just do the right thing.
Now, how costly is this process, and what does it mean for deep isolation and your own funding needs moving forward?
Yeah, so we've done a lot of economic studies, and we're about half the cost of this typical mined repository that countries have been trying to develop for over the last few decades. And so we can be much more cost effective, and we can deploy modularly. So you could put this at a reactor site and not have to transport the fuel anywhere. So we're working hand in hand with a lot of the new advanced reactor companies and trying to make sure that they're thinking about the back end as they do the front end. One of the things deep isolation is trying to do is get funding for a full scale at depth demonstration. Our nuclear clients and customers are not experienced with oil and gas and how sophisticated that can be. And our oil and gas partners are not as sophisticated in nuclear handling and how safe that can be. And so we're marrying those two together. And we just need to kind of show this all work so people can come out and kick the tires, so to speak.
Rod, it's kind of remarkable to be having a conversation like this when it wasn't that long ago. It was only a few years ago, this idea that nuclear energy and the demand for it is being left for dead. It seems like it is AI that has revived the sector and the demand for it. But still, at the same time, only two new traditional reactors have been added in recent years in the U.S. None are in the works. Realistically, does that change, or is a lot of it just hype right now?
No, I definitely see it changing. And, you know, this is AI data centers and just, you know, progress that we make every year. And so the need for electricity is real. We've tapped a lot of other fuel types, and nuclear is a very consistent baseload, steady producer. And so it is something that's clean, and you can add it in there. It's not has been. It takes a long time to develop, and it's expensive. So if we can start producing these more regularly, like we used to, I think that drives the cost down and it really opens that up. But we also need to make sure we're planned for the whole life cycle. And so we do the whole thing. We can do that here in the U.S., and we should do that again.
I also want to point to another force in your favor, which is just law, right? Because you have the Supreme Court leaving intact a plan to store as much as 40,000 tons of highly radioactive waste at a site in West Texas as one big example of a wind towards your industry. What kind of difference does the Supreme Court decision make?
It's an interesting decision. So it basically said that the NRC can license this facility, but I think everybody in nuclear also knows that, you know, the state has to get on board. Texas has been very opposed to that. They've been very vocal about that. And we can't force nuclear waste onto somebody who doesn't want it. And so that's the kind of purpose for deep isolation. You don't have to have one centralized repository where all the waste in the nation is going to go. You can do it where it's just your reactor. So as you benefit from those jobs, that property tax, those economic incentives, you also can take care of that waste. It doesn't have to sit there above ground in storage for 100 years and not really know when it would ever be taken away. You can put more of this back in your own control.